Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX have yet to launch the Starlink 434 mission. They posted a tweet saying Falcon 9's launch of Starlink is now targeted for Saturday, September 17th at 8:43 p.m. Eastern Time as weather continues to remain unfavorable for tonight's launch attempt. There was another tweet by SpaceX saying now targeting Sunday, September 18th at 8:18 p.m. Eastern Time for Falcon 9's launch of Starlink. After this Starlink 434 mission, we can hopefully expect another Starlink launch not long after. As you can see on the SpaceXFans website, the launch of Starlink 435 is scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 19th at 5:56 p.m. UTC or 1:56 p.m. EDT. Polaris posted a picture of the crew in training on Twitter. They said, "Our crew completed their first week of EVA training practicing maneuvers necessary to move in and out of Dragon during a spacewalk. They also reviewed development of EVA technology and lessons learned from the last 50 years. There was a thread following on from this tweet ending with Jared Isaacman posting a tweet. "The first response asks, is the whole capsule going to get depressurized during the EVA? And how many of you are planning to perform the spacewalk? All four?" Next, there was a tweet posted saying, "I've heard the entire capsule would depressurize and only one person EVA. But I also remember a possibility of more people on EVA since they'll already need spacesuits." After that, somebody said, "Entire capsule would depressurize like Gemini. No way it can have an airlock. I'm 99.9% sure." Jared said two people will spacewalk one at a time and which two hasn't been decided yet. Betcha he's one of them. Finally, Jared Isaacman tweeted, "Correct, the entire cabin will vent down to vacuum and there will be two crew members that will exit the vehicle. Heading to Boca Chica, workers continued on the orbital launch mount. Crews were seen working on the tracking camera setup atop the midbay. I wanted to share this tweet by somebody who posted pictures of their tour at Kennedy Space Center. In these pictures, you can see how quickly SpaceX are progressing with the Starship launch pad in Florida. In the pictures is the booster quick disconnect hood being delivered to LC-39A. The stacked Ship 25 nose cone was seen being welded to the tank section. At some point, the Ship 26 nose cone was rolled outside without heat shield tiles. The Ship 26 nose cone was seen moved in the production yard. It was moved to outside the high bay. Later, it was then moved back over to the windbreak. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closure, SpaceX did some further spin prime testing on Friday. They also have possible closures scheduled for this coming week with tomorrow, Monday 19th and Tuesday 20th. This super heavy booster 9 section was seen lifted and stacked inside the mega bay. As always, I have to say thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content in this video. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.